Hello there. Today's video guides us through the realm of access scopes in GCP. We're going to dive hands-on into this practical exercise, but before we plunge in, let's address the theory. Picture this. We have a Compute Engine VM or another service on Google Cloud. This could be a serverless setup, and we need to access a different GCP service. Let's say, for illustrative purposes, we want to reach out to cloud storage. We encounter our first hurdle, ensuring the right permissions are in place. We'll liaise with the service account via Identity and Access Management and set up GCS type roles. However, we also have gatekeeping around which services can be reached at all based on access scopes. On the permissions side, let's use the Compute Engine default service account where we'll inspect the automatically applied editor permissions for illustration. When we look at the permissions for that role, we'll see a set of permissions over cloud storage. However, these privileges are solely for storage buckets. They don't extend to the storage objects within the buckets. Shall we embark on a quest to expand these permissions a touch? We return to IAM, pick the Compute Engine service account, and endow it with the authority of a storage admin role at the project level. With this power bestowed, we've completed part one. The final step calls for access scopes. Without this, our permissions are essentially worthless. Let's demonstrate this by trying to list buckets in a VM with the service account. However, we won't give that VM any real access scopes. Even with the required permissions, we're blocked. So, back to Compute Engine service we go, and into the VM instance editing. We need to halt the VM to make changes to the access scopes. Now our access scopes need a bit of tweaking. We could stick with setting access for each API, or we could pick a pre-built option, which includes sensible read and write access scopes across key services like the CloudOps suite. Let's rev up the VM and put our change to the test. Well, our VM is all set and running. So let's dive into an SSH session to check the setup. Let's list our buckets as an example. And voila! So, we've nailed down both the security aspects comprehensively. We've got our permissions and our access scopes for the secure connection to cloud storage and where all systems go. We'll keep an eye on the comments section for any questions, and we thank you very much for tuning in. Please enjoy responsibly.